When we first got our truck and fifth wheel for our full-time travels, one of the things that really bothered me was constantly moving stuff in and out of the truck bed because we did not have a cover. This meant that our stuff could fly out while driving, was exposed to all types of weather, and was visible to thieves. We were especially worried about big ticket items like generators, power cords, and tools. After exhaustive research, I decided on the Roll and Lock rolling retractable cover. About a year ago, I did a video installing the cover with some custom modifications so that the cover could be partially closed while hitching to our fifth wheel. It was not a product review video because we don't like to review a product unless we've had actual experience with it. I will leave a link right up here to that install video. I am now ready to do an honest review with over a year's experience with the cover, which includes 2 trips from Florida to Canada and moving every week to 2 weeks, letting you know what I like and don't like about the Roll and Lock. This is a completely unbiased review as we have no affiliation with Roll and Lock. We purchased the cover with our own money at full retail price. First, let me go over how the cover works. You pull on the strap to close it. You close the gate. You pull the cover close until it clicks in place and locks to the gate. You take your key, rotate it, close the key for cover. Now it's locked. Now to open the cover after it's been locked, first you have to unlock the truck. Make sure the tailgate's unlocked. Put your key in, rotate the key, turn it, and then turn the cam, pull your key out. You gotta make sure you pull your key out because when you push it back, it can snap off the key. Let it slide back a little bit. Open your tailgate. Now when it was new, it would slide back all on its own. But now that it's a little older and it's sticky, you gotta kind of give it a good push so it pops back into place. It's really important for the cover to make it all the way back to the canister because that's how it clicks the locker so that when I go to open it again, it rotates the cam into this position so it'll stop and lock into position. Like there's that first locking position. Now the cover comes with 3 stock locking positions. Once the cam is all the way down in the back and the cam is turned, there's the first locking position. This is the second stock locking position right there. And here's the 3rd locking position right there. Of course, it also locks all the way closed. Now, to reset the locking positions, you have to rotate the cam and then push it all the way back until the cam is rotated back at the canister again. Now you can pull it closed again, 1 click at a time, the first locking position. Now I have a custom locking position right here. This helps me maximize the covered space in the back of the truck, but still gives me full access to the fifth wheel kingpin and the hitch. I'm gonna start with things that I like about this cover. When not towing the fifth wheel, the cover keeps our cargo secure, dry, and out of all types of weather, especially the sun. Some water can get in around the edges, but it's minimal. I keep most of the stuff in containers with lids anyways. This allows us to keep a lot of our heavy items in the back of the truck to keep the weight down in the RV. While towing, it keeps half of the truck bed covered. This means that everything under that half stays dry and secure while speeding down the highway and at truck stops. The cover keeps the sun off our extra gas and diesel containers. We travel with 2 2.5-gallon containers of gas for our generators and a 5-gallon container of diesel for emergencies, which we've used several times. It locks easily and securely. Can it be broken into? Of course, but it won't be easy. Plus, thieves can't see what's in the bed of the truck, like our B&W companion hitch. It would cost almost $1,500 to replace. The hitch has a lock of its own, but the cover is another layer of security. This cover does not block your view while backing into the hitch, unlike hard folding stacking type covers that do. Rolling canister covers are the only ones that I could find that were secure and did not block the view at all. It has a very low truck bed rail profile. The amount of space that you have between the bed rail and the fifth wheel is very important when traveling on uneven terrain. You do not want your fifth wheel to make contact with the bed rail, causing damage to either or both. The rolling lock reduces the space between the bed rail and the fifth wheel by only half an inch. Since the day I installed the rolling lock, I have not had to adjust or tighten the system at all. It has worked really well since the day I finished the install, except for this freaking strap. Now for the things I do not like about the rolling lock. This freaking strap sucks. I can't tell you how many times I have cursed this strap. Every time I went to pull the cover closed, the strap was caught on something. It made me so crazy. It would also flap around while towing, causing a distraction. I eventually came up with this strap solution, which reduces the swearing significantly. Now, the strap system that came with the cover was just this plain strap. You attach it here to the back of the truck, like I talked about earlier. The problem was it catches on everything, which just drives me nuts. So I came with this elastic system, which helps keep the strap out of the way when the cover's open all the way. So I'll push the cover open all the way. And you can see here, this elastic right here keeps the strap nice and tight and above all the stuff in the back of the truck, which really makes a difference. So when I go to close it, it's always right here above. There's nothing I'm gonna put on top of it. It's just less likely to catch on things in the back of the truck, which is really nice. So when I go to close it, I just pull on the strap and I don't have to worry about it catching on anything. It's still not flawless. It still catches on stuff and still makes me crazy, but just not as crazy as it used to. Now, the other purpose of this strap, let me close it all the way again, or open it all the way, so I can open it again. Now, when I have this custom locking position right here in front of the fifth wheel hitch, when I'm driving down the road, I wanted to make sure that one, the strap didn't blow around and make me crazy, because it blows around and like this and it just goes crazy, right? So I didn't like that. So I created a knot in this strap right here, and they have another carabiner here tied underneath, and this clicks on here like that. This does two things. One, it keeps it from blowing around in the wind and driving me crazy. And then also, if for some reason my locking position became undone or somehow I hit a bump, and the locking positions can slide, it minimizes how much the truck bed will open, because the strap will keep it from opening up all the way and keep most of my stuff covered in the back of the truck. Rolling Lock does offer an electric version that does not use the strap, but it cost $1,000 more, and that was definitely not in our budget. Some maintenance is required. It has a drainage system so that water that collects on the top of the cover drains into the canister, which has drain holes and drainage tubes in the bottom of it. But the canister does get leaves, pollen and bugs and other debris in it if you close the top with junk on it. So debris has to be cleaned out of the canister periodically to reduce blockage of the drainage holes in the canister or the tubes that connect to the drainage holes. If you get a lot of water on the cover and it blocks the drains, the canister will fill with water, and that's not good for the cover. The cover is vinyl and must be cared for. They give you this little tube of 303 protectant when you buy your cover. If you take care of the vinyl, it should last for years, even in the harsh sun like we have in Florida. Every couple of months, I clean and protect with the 303. Though the rail slides also have to be lubed to keep them sliding well. I just rub them with the rag that I use for applying the protectant to the cover. The canister, which houses the roller, does take up some space in the bed of the truck. I use these four containers, which fit perfectly under the canister, so I can utilize all of that space. The canister takes up 12 inches by 8 inches, and there's 11¾ inches space underneath it for me to put my bins like that. Do you need a truck bed cover? Yes, especially if you're a full-timer towing an RV. You're able to keep a lot of heavy stuff in the back of the truck instead of adding weight to the RV. And you're able to keep that stuff in the back dry and secure. And it keeps the stuff from flying out of the truck while on the highway. It keeps potential thieves from seeing your property. If they can't see that expensive stuff back there, they're less tempted. They're not likely to break into the cover just to see what you might have in the back there worth stealing. The cover is a great theft deterrent. And of course,
the cover makes your truck look so much cooler, which is important. I am so glad we purchased and installed the roller lock cover on our Ram 3500. I cannot imagine having a fifth wheel in a truck without a cover. It is so useful. Now, would I buy the roller lock again, or would I buy a different brand? If I could go back in time, I would take a better look at the Retrax Pro because it does not have the annoying strap to deal with. Other than the strap system, I love our roller lock A-Series cover. Are you looking for a truck bed cover, or do you already have one? Please share your cover story in the comments. Do you have a Retrax Pro? I would really love to hear what you have to say about your experience. We do lots of product review videos like this, campground tours, RV DIY projects, and of course, full-time RV travel adventures. If you like that kind of stuff, please consider subscribing to our channel by clicking this link below. That would really help us out. I will also leave a link to our first roll and lock video where I go over the installation right over here. And remember, downsizing does make sense.